Hey everyone! In today's video I will show you three different ways to go from dark to light in oil painting, and I will explain when it is best to use each one of these methods. The materials I'm using in this demonstration is a canvas paper artist pad from Royal and Langnickel. I'm keeping it simple, I'm not using anything fancy just because it's a simple demonstration. Several colors and types of Winsor & Newton oil paints. A medium for oil painting from Winsor & Newton, simple makeup brushes, and a glass frame that I'm using for a palette. If you'd like to know more about the materials I'm using generally in oil painting, I've already made a video about this. I will link it below in the description and put a link for it in the video so that you can go and watch it if you're interested in that. Now, on to the first way that you can go from dark to light in oil painting is the wet on wet technique. That means that you put on the first layer, the dark layer on the bottom, and before it is dry, right away, you go ahead and add a lighter color on top. This method is recommended for smoother transitions and milder changes in color. In this method, the two colors are naturally mixing when you take the wet paint and put it on the wet underlayer. So, even if you take white and put it on top of blue-black, the white will not stay white. It will mix with the blue-black, create a variation of colors and values in between the blue-black and the white. This is exactly why this method is best for smooth transitions, for not very sudden changes in color, and for when you want to lighten up a color without making sharp edges and sudden changes. Obviously, the more you blend with your brush, the more smooth the transition is. If you want slightly sharper edges, you can just put the color on top and let it be. Exactly because the colors are mixing when you're using this method, the wet-on-wet method, you should be very careful with the colors you pick. If you have a blue-black underlayer, as I am using here, and you want a bright orange on top, there is no way you can do that with this method. If you put the orange on top of the blue-black, the blue will get absorbed from the orange and will create a greenish hue, which is probably not what you're going for. So to sum this up, it is best for smoother transitions, be careful with the colors you're using, and don't overdo it with the blending because the darker color almost always wins. The second method I'm going to talk about is wet on dry with opaque colors. I've already mentioned in my previous video what opaque and transparent colors are. Oil painting has both types. And in this technique, we're going to put an opaque color on top of a dry underlayer of a very dark color. This method works well for sharper edges, sudden transitions in color, and for the colors you wouldn't be using together in the previous method. For example, putting orange on top of a blue-black. You can use a dry brush for some smoothness and the effect you're watching me create right now. You can leave it as is for fine details, maybe single hairs and fur. And in this method, you can even erase and completely change whole areas of color. You might have to go twice over it for a complete change, but it is very possible. Not every bright color is opaque. Some of them are transparent, and you might want to use one of those. But if you go on top of a blue-black or a black with a transparent color, bright color, it will not make much of a change. You can see here that it changes the hue just a little bit. If you, I'm not sure if it shows on the camera, but if you look at it from up close, you can see the difference, but it's definitely not lighter. In this case, the secret is to let the dark color dry, go on top of it with a white, let the white dry as well, and then go on top of the white with your transparent color. I think it's more than obvious how huge the difference is now. The white is creating the perfect underlayer for a transparent color to go on top and be bright and colorful as it should be. You can also combine the first method with this method, meaning that if the white at the bottom is not completely white, the transparent color on top will not be completely bright. So you can use this mid layer or generally the bottom layer, to predict how bright the transparent color will be on top. And that's about it. These are the three main methods you can use to go from dark to light in oil painting. If you have any questions, make sure to leave them in the comments below. I will make sure to answer each and every one of them, and I will be more than happy to create extra videos if you need extra explanation on something specific. If you liked this video and found it informative, please leave it a thumbs up. If you'd like to see more like this, consider subscribing to my channel. I will be uploading weekly. I hope to see you on the next video. Until then, be safe, be happy, and keep going for your dreams. Bye!